Welcome to the Fathom Event screening of Sleepless in Seattle. I'm producer Gary Foster here in New York City. I can't quite believe it's been 25 years since the film was first released. Sleepless has clearly stood the test of time. I still have people who approach me to share their love of the film, and I'm excited to share it with you today. We had amazing leads in Meg Ryan and Tom Hanks, an extremely strong supporting ensemble cast, and a director with a sharp wit and brilliant eye who could bring it all together. Whether you are watching it again, thank you, or for the very first time, welcome. I hope you'll enjoy it as much as the entire cast and crew enjoyed making it. And here is a little trivia for you. When you hear "Disappointed in Denver" on the radio, that's director Nora Ephron herself making a cameo. And speaking of cameos, I made one too. If you look behind Tom Hanks in the restaurant scene where he has his first date, you'll see me, 25 years younger, no gray hair. Enjoy the show.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. So, Meg Ryan, we are here in New York where we shot the last day of this movie, Sleepless in Seattle.
Was that the only day we shot in New York?
We shot a day and a half here, and it was, and I think we talked about this recently, the last shot was you running down Fifth Avenue toward the
right.
Empire State Building in
which
shoes that you said were...
did not fit.
did not fit.
Didn't we, I remember Nora knocking on my trailer door one morning, she said, just
that's right.
Remember this. She kept saying, this doesn't happen. Yeah. Remember this.
Enjoy these yeah. moments. No, she was great.
Yeah. She approached me, or you approached me, with Sleepless in Seattle.
I did first without her.
Without her.
And then I hired her, and then she said, I'm writing this for Meg. She needs to play this part.
Okay. So she had a lot of faith in me by then, so that was really lovely.
Tom. Why do you think you guys work so well together? Why do you think there's three wonderful movies with you guys starring together?
He's just so easy. He listens. He roots for other people.
As a film lover, there's something elevated about watching you two on screen. I don't know what it is. But
well,
it
I know
just,
too. He yeah. doesn't like there to be drama. I don't think either
yeah.
on the set. And I
yeah.
feel the same. Like we just are really there to have fun. We're supposed to be. This is supposed to be a creative experience, and it's. There's no reason to get heavy. The choice Nora made about this movie not just being about love, but about love in the movies
right.
was really clever.
That's your problem. You don't want to be in love. You want to be in love in a movie.
And there's a real innocence about it too. I mean, as sophisticated and cynical as Nora could be, she could really create these innocent worlds. And she really did a movie like she did a dinner party. One of my favorite things about being around her as a director, because she directed like a writer. She directed like somebody was secretly listening from the New Yorker and was going to quote her. She'd always have these beautiful, like almost like little chocolate covered cherries to give you, and then you go, oh, I know what she's talking about.
Yeah.
It was like
magic.
Why do you think this movie 25 years later still resonates with people?
I think it has something to do with the hope we all have that we're being taken care of in the way by fate, in the way that this movie suggests that destiny is in charge and is leading you on the right path.
The idea was that whether you watch the film in 1993 or 2018, mm-hmm. it feels relevant visually.
The number of people who tell me they see Sleepless in Seattle and they love Sleepless in Seattle, and how many people tell me they watch it from bed when they're sick. Because it just makes them feel so much better.
Yeah.
And
it is. It's one of those great feel-good stories.
And secretly, I think that's the good feeling of Sleepless in Seattle.